Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and yesterday Apple released macOS Monterey 12.3 Beta 1. It's now available to developers, and usually within 24 hours or so, it will be released to public beta testers. If it is not, it will probably be next week. This came in at 4.21 gigabytes. That's on an M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch, but this can vary in size depending on if you are on 12.2 release candidate like this Mac, or the public version of 12.2, which then it has to reinstall the whole OS to go to the beta version, and this could be a much larger install at 12 gigabytes. It just depends which version you're on. Now, along with this, Apple also released iOS 15.4 Beta 1, iPadOS 15.4 Beta 1, WatchOS 8.5 Beta 1, and tvOS 15.4 Beta 1. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new, as this has some very exciting features in it, or at least one very exciting feature. Now, as you can see, this is 12.3 beta, and here is the build number, 21E5196i. This just tells us that we're on the correct version that's currently available. So we'll go ahead and close this out, and the first major feature is universal control. We've been waiting for this since the announcement of iOS 15 and iPadOS 15, along with macOS Monterey. So let me show you how that works, but at first we need to enable it by going to our system preferences. Now typically it's enabled by default, but you can see it under displays, and under displays you'll see we have advanced. Under advanced, we'll go into advanced, and you'll see we have it enabled here. It says allow your cursor and keyboard to move between any nearby Mac or iPad. Your cursor and keyboard can be used on any nearby Mac or iPad signed into your iCloud account. Also, you have push through the edge of the display to connect a nearby Mac or iPad, and you also have an option to automatically reconnect to any nearby Mac or iPad. This was not checked by default for me. Compatibility is from 2016 Macs and later for the most part, with the exception of the 5K iMac, which is supported on this as well. So the 2015 5K iMac, and you need Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and handoff turned on and must be within 10 meters or so of each other. If you're planning to use this with an iPad as well, I'll show you that in my demo, you'll need an iPad Pro, an iPad Air 3rd generation or later, an iPad 6th generation or later, or an iPad Mini 5th generation and later. Now let me show you how this works. For universal control to work, what you'll need to do is have the settings on the Mac, like I said, with 12.3 Beta 1, as well as iPadOS 15.4 Beta 1. Go to your settings, under General, go to AirPlay and Handoff, make sure Cursor and Keyboard Beta is turned on. Once you have that on, it should work. So we'll just put it on the Magic Keyboard here to make this a little easier, and with our cursor on the MacBook, we'll just drag it to the right corner, give it just a moment here, and we'll try again, and you'll see it sort of pops into the side of the iPad. Drag it over, and there you go. So now it works. I can control the iPad with the Mac keyboard and mouse or trackpad, go to Apple, maybe click in here, type apple.com, you'll see the keyboard works. Hit enter and it will load. The same is true using the Magic Keyboard on the iPad to go over to the Mac. So we can drag over to the left here. You'll see it's working on the key or on the screen. We'll go to Safari and again type apple.com and hit return or enter. And there we go, and we can load it back and forth. So it works back and forth. It works with that as well as third-party accessories such as the Magic Trackpad. So if I drag here, you'll see that it's controlling it on my screen with the trackpad, and again, it's working over here. So if you have a Bluetooth trackpad or mouse paired, it will work with that as well. You can also drag and drop files and more. So maybe you want to drag and drop a file, maybe this wallpaper here. We'll drag and drop, we'll drag this one over. Maybe we'll drag it over here. You'll see it's dragging 11 download files or folders. And so it may have some issues here and there as it is in beta, but it does work and you can go back and forth between the devices with it. Now there's some updates as well with macOS that also are from iPadOS. So not just universal control, but other things as well. If you have AirPods, AirPods Pro, or any of those, and you need to update the firmware, there's now code in macOS 12.3 that will allow this. Now, unfortunately, there's no manual updater as we had hoped for, but you can have them updated. So if you don't have an iPhone or iPad, what you'll do is just pair these to your Mac, go to your Bluetooth, pair them. Once they're paired, then you plug these in, maybe have them charge here, make sure they're charged well, usually over 50%, close them, set them aside, and just wait for them to update. 9to5 Mac was able to confirm they were able to get them to update by doing that process. So there's no specific process to do that. Maybe one day we'll get a manual updater, but at least they'll update for you. Also, just like on iOS 15.4, macOS 12.3 adds additional support for the PS5 DualSense controller, in the sense that you get the adaptive trigger support now. So now developers can develop games enabling the adaptive triggers with haptic feedback. So if you've ever used these are the best triggers for different platforming games, Call of Duty, things like that, and now developers can have access to that. So that's something they've added in this update. So that's great to see. Within this update, within Messages, we have 37 new emoji. This is to comply with the latest Unicode standard 14, just like they do every year. They've added this to iOS, iPadOS, WatchOS, and macOS. And you can see them here. So you have an X-ray and bubbles. This is all the different ones. You have a nest with eggs, a nest without eggs. You have a palm facing up, a palm facing down, palm facing left and right, a melting face, and different skin tones to go along with that. So 37 different changes along with different skin tones to match. So those are available in this update as well. Now also they've updated TV. So if we go into the TV app, there's some new preferences. So within TV, if we go to TV and then preferences, you'll see that we have under general, we now have an up next display, where it says choose the art you want to see in your up next watch list. Still frame shows still frames from what you're watching. Poster art shows the main title images for the shows or movies. So you can select still frame or poster art. Either one is there, and that's up to you. So that's just a new option within TV. Additionally, within keychain, there's a new space as well. So if we go into preferences, and then we find our keychain or our passwords. Within our passwords, I've created a test password. This isn't a real one, but if we go to edit, under edit, we now have a notes field. So we can leave a note, maybe make a note about this specific password. Maybe it's an old password. And we can just leave that, click save, and it saves across our devices. So that's something they've updated as well. Now within Safari, there's now a passkey extension. And what that means is if you have a supported website, support for passkey technology allows you to sign in to different passkey compatible websites and apps on Mac and iPad using an iPhone with a saved passkey. So that's now available. Of course, the website has to support that. Once it's enabled, you'll be able to use that. Now there is something else worth noting. Kernel extensions that have been deprecated. So within 12.3, it deprecates a kernel extension which is used for Dropbox and Microsoft OneDrive. However, Apple notes that both companies have cloud storage fixes currently in beta. So if you use either of those, you may want to wait to update. Now, additionally, they've added the option for iCloud Plus custom email domains. Now this is available in 15.4, but within macOS 12.3, you'll have to go to iCloud.com to set that up. So it's not enabled within this beta, according to Apple. It's sort of here, but there's no option to go to it from any of the preferences or the mail app. And they've mentioned that specifically. And that's one of the known issues within this update. There are 7 known issues. That's one of the notable ones that I just mentioned, but also some connection issues that can happen with universal control, and also virtual machines running on Apple Silicon are not currently able to install this beta. So those are some things to note. If you're looking to install the beta, you won't be able to do that. They've also resolved some issues, so they've fixed some issues with shortcuts, Xcode, and text, but most of them are developer-focused or within the underlying code. So a few different fixes here, but nothing specific that's large that may be forward-facing that you'll see right away. That leads me to, should you install macOS 12.3 Beta 1? Well, considering the different things that I've mentioned with the known issues, if you wanted to try it with a virtual machine, you actually can't. However, there are some notable issues, and if that's a problem for you, such as Dropbox and Microsoft OneDrive, well, then I wouldn't install it. However, if you have an extra machine, you want to try it out, try out Universal Control, you definitely could do that. Go into your displays, mess around with that, with your iPad and more on 15.4, you could definitely do that. But just keep in mind, you will have some bugs. So if you're trying to fix an issue, I typically recommend against installing betas on your main production machine. I don't install them on a production machine because there could always be bugs that could affect my production, such as Final Cut and more. So typically I would wait. Also, if you're wondering when to expect maybe Beta 2 or the final release, well, currently, I wouldn't expect Beta 2 next week. Usually, we're on a couple-week cycle or a bi-weekly cycle, so maybe the second week of February, we'll see some sort of Beta 2 with a final release, typically within March or so. But we don't know for sure, and Apple hasn't specified a date yet, so probably within the first week of March, but we could have one sooner or even later than that. We just don't know at this point. Maybe we'll have a spring event in March as well. As far as performance and everything else, well, performance seems okay. I'm screen recording. It's working just fine. It's nice and smooth. So it seems like it's okay. So performance should be the same as macOS Monterey, but you could have some bugs here and there. And battery life, if you're running a Mac like I am, a MacBook, you'll see battery life here. Seems to be okay, but there's no way to know, and running betas will always give you some issues from time to time, so if you're hoping to get great battery life, I would stay away from the beta. You'll see the capacity on this one is 99%, and it's normal for the battery condition. So no issues there, seems to be running fine, and hopefully we'll see some additional features by the time it's released, but then we'll be on to macOS 13 by the time WWDC rolls around in June. So that's everything with macOS 12.3 Beta 1. If I find anything else, I'll be sure to let you know in future videos. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link the iPhone version in the description below. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.